for all situations, the good, the bad, the difficult, the really easy, and even the stressful, Lord. We just thank you that we know that you can work in all things, Lord. In Jesus I pray, amen.
Enjoy the show!
I try to get a good night. Kabuto.
We are on a land of Pharaoh's boy and our new sustenance. You got any?
Unfortunately, you only have fries and shakes.
Gnarly! We will take a dozen each!
JD, we probably have enough food as this. They'll ruin us!
No, they'll help us. I have an idea. Excuse me, but
who are you?
Thank you.
pressure.
I think she means you.
I'm our tweaky, Mr. Kahuna. Please, you can call me Great. thank you. Great. And you can call me Joe. So, Joe, how long have you been on my beach?
I don't know.
How did you get here? How long will you stay? When will you leave?
I don't know. I really don't.
It appears you know much about anything, do you, Joe?
Well, my friend Coco and I, we're just talking about that. We're trying to trust God with all things we don't know.
Him? There's not much need for God on this beach. After all, we have me. Captain Shuby.
Yes, sir?
I trust this young and confused man to your care. Find him a job that'll give him a sense of direction.
I'll do my best, sir.
Joe, this is Captain Shuby, my deputy. You'll be working for her. These are my assistants, Orchid and her business. They'll show you the ropes. Good luck, Joe. Even with your gun, you'll need it. Wow, Coco, imagine. I've already been here less than a day, and you already have a job.
Don't get too excited, Joe. Kahuna does not treat his workers very well. A lot of them say they feel like slaves.
Don't be mean. See, I'm the best worker they've ever seen.
So, Joe, what can you do?
I've been told I can turn my dreams real well.
Oh, that's useful. Well, since we don't have any openings for a dream interpreter, at present, you'll be assigned a different position on the beach.
Like what? Will I be a VP or CEO?
No, you're a TF.
What's a TF?
Towel folder!
Oh,
job had to sit before the great kahuna. He needed a job and a place to stay. But now kahuna needed something from the job.
Everyone says that you interpret dreams well. Is that so?
Actually, sir, it's not.
It's not?
Nope. God is the one who interprets the dreams, not me. He will reveal what it means.
I see. It seems there is a need for God on this beach. And now, I'll tell you my dream.
And so, Kahuna shared his dream with Joe. The dream was indeed strange and perplexing. Every creature on the beach was starving, and none of the coconut trees had coconuts. And God revealed to Joe what it meant.
The time of fun and sun might only be for a season. It's drawn to a close. Can't you hear the thunder in the distance? A storm is on the way, and it'll cause much destruction. Not only on the beach, but throughout the mainland. Food and water will be short supplied. What can we do? We must begin to prepare immediately. And so we will. Captain Shuby, gather everyone up. Joe, I'm promoting you to lifeguard. You'll lead the operation. Now, where is that girl that sells the omni-conceived water?
Coco's walking water hole at your service, your kahuna ship.
Good. Coco, you lead the food and water stations. You need to help a bunch of people after the storm passes. You picked the right girl for that job, sir.
I knew God had a plan for me.
Attention, everyone. Time to stock up and hunker down. Captain Chewie, sound the alarm.
And so the storm descended over the one sunny beach, but with Joe giving directions, staying in the big by the safety. Joe, she was never going to make it.
Oh, there's floating water.
Thank you.
and fast, he had a hard time even remembering that former life. Until one day that former life arrived on the back of a bunch of choppers.
It was the crew, the Papa Jake's Fried Shakes, and they were hungry.
Welcome to Ferris Point, everyone. It looks like you traveled a long way.
We swim a driving up north. My name is Jaden, and these are my brothers and sisters.
We're real hungry. We heard about supplies to share.
We do. I'm sure we can help you. If you just talk to our governor over there, he'll make sure your needs are met.
Now, Joe was seated up high in the lifeguard tower, and as soon as he saw his brothers and sisters, he recognized them, but they didn't know it was Joe. He was tanned, his clothes were different, and the sun was in their eyes. But then, Joe came down from the lifeguard stand to talk to them.
I see you traveled a great distance. Had you come to find food?
Yes, Governor. We had a little food to spare before, but now it's completely gone.
We used to know driving up north, but the storm destroyed it.
I'm sorry. Was anyone hurt?
No, everyone made it out in time.
We heard that somehow. You knew that the storm would come, and that you had saved many supplies.
We were hoping that we might buy some.
Oh, no, sir. Our food isn't for sale. It's free.
Free?
This is my assistant, Coco. She's in charge of food and watering stations.
We're pleased to meet you.
We might not have any extra food at this time.
Governor, what do you say?
Coco and I don't have to check the inventory. Please come back in the morning and we'll give you our decision.
We understand. Thank you, sir. We'll see you then.
This was a turn of events that Joe did not expect. He was deeply surprised to see his family after so much time. Even more surprised, how that made him feel.
Joe, why did you say that? We have more than enough supplies, and we've pledged to help any stranger in need.
They aren't strangers, Coco. They're my brothers and sisters.
Your brothers and sisters? You told me that they sent you away while your father was out of town.
That's all true, but that was a long time ago, when the summer first started. You seemed to have changed.
They didn't recognize you.
No, they didn't. Sure, I've changed as well.
What are you gonna do, Joe?
I don't know. Look, the sun just set. Maybe I'll sit at the beach for a while and count the stars. I really did that once.
Count the stars, huh? You know, that might be a lot easier on top of your tower.
No, I think I can see God a lot more clearly down here.
But you're on your knees.
Exactly. I've been praying. And I'm starting to realize that even though my brothers and sisters did something terrible to me, God must have wanted to use it for good.
You're right, Joe. God had a plan for your family. He brought you here so you could provide them and us with food to save all of our lives. I think you know God wants you to save to your family, Joe.
Yes, I do know. God has forgiven all the wrong things I've done. But that makes it less than ever to my sisters.
They're the ones who sent you here, Joe. But it was God at work all along. And I can see he's at work with you, too. Helping you forgive.
We never know sir. We hope you reconsider our request.
I had to take stock of many things last night. Our storehouse is full. Well, we're flying, actually. And so I'll have to give you whatever you need.
Thank you, sir! We'll spend the work that the governor is supposed to just run the land!
No, JD. I'm not who you think I am. I'm not a ruler. I'm not even from this speech.
You're not?
I'm Joe, your brother. The one who sent to Pharaoh's Point so many months ago.
I don't believe it! Oh, Joe, please forgive us!
We all wonder what happened to you.
JD said it would teach you a lesson.
I have been many lessons. JD?
Yes?
Please stand, my brother.
And so Joe descended his tower and approached his family that he had not seen in so long. They were terrified, but Joe's words were just full of love and kindness.
It was God who sent me to save lives, the lives of people on the beach, throughout the mainland, and especially your lives. No matter how great grandpa and baby, you say that the whole world would be blessed through our family.
I do remember. Please forgive us, Joe. What we did was very wrong.
Yes, your actions were meant to hurt, but God used them for good. Now tell me about our father. Is he still living? Did he survive the storm?
Indeed he did! The restaurant was gone. And so were all of you. I am afraid that you guys have found somewhere safe to stay. Then everyone told me a story about this beach and a very wise man who can understand dreams, for whoever that came to him would be saved.
No, Papa. It was God who interpreted the dreams. It was God who chose to store food. It was God who saved lives. God has been with me all this time. Just like you told me, he was also with you.
Yes, and has brought us back together again.
Oh.